One of the benefits of GPA or using any of the Microsoft products is that you're in a SQL Server database. And what that means is that you're in the industry standard database. All of the GPA information is stored in a standard file storage, and it means that we can use these reporting tools to tap into the information you want. And so SSRS is a suite of tools for creating reports. And so using data sources and parameters and et cetera, you can go ahead and be able to take your GP data and not just be able to export it out, but be able to do what I call the highly formatted repeatable reports. I mean, a lot of people are probably using SmartList to do tons of stuff, pushing it out. Hopefully you're using Excel Report Builder to update the information. But this is something a little bit different, where you can go ahead and just do some great looking reports with some parameters, and this is where people can go ahead and just be able to ask for the information they need when they need it. And you can either deploy these reports browser or SharePoint-based reports. So if you're using SharePoint, all of these reports can reside on SharePoint. If you're not using SharePoint, you can just look them up from a browser. It also has the ability to schedule reports. So if you find there's those, you know, five sales reports you need every single month, you can go ahead and just use the scheduling features of SSRS to automate the delivery of those reports. And then people can subscribe to the reports. Sorry, I'm in my throat. So the schedule is out there, and people just want to be alerted via SharePoint that the reports are now available, and they can go up and go ahead and take a look at them. So when you use SharePoint, you use the scheduler, and you use the subscriptions, you get complete end-to-end automation. So just a brief little slide on the architecture of this. We have over here the report manager. That's where you go ahead and view the report. A lot of this is done in .NET. The web services, which is how it's going ahead and calling the information from the database to create the report. And then in the background, there's some report processing happening. It's rendering the report, it's doing the scheduling, it's doing the delivery and the database maintenance. So these reports, the SSRS reports, work live off the SQL Server database. So you don't have to get them into something else. You don't have to export the data and then report on it. As you're putting entries into GPA, you can just report directly off of that. Okay, so why would you use SSRS? And there's a couple of reasons why. One is that it consolidates the reporting tools. If the information is inside GPA, you can get to it. You might need to know some table names or know the data dictionary a little bit, but you can report off anything that's inside GPA, and you can link information together. So it takes advantage of SQL Server. So it lays right on top of it. This is real time. It's a direct access to your SQL Server database, which in essence is your GP data. But over and above that, you can also include non-GP data. So if you're using an operation system and maybe that's inside SQL Server as well and you have that synergy there, you can just link the two tables together if you can find a common field. If it's not, you can also bring Excel files in, or you can use other non-SQL data. And you can also deploy this either to IIS or to SharePoint. So you've got some deployment options there as well. But this is one of the takeaways here that's pretty important, is that if you want to bridge your GP and your non-GP data, and they're both in SQL Server, then this is definitely the tool to use. Okay, so these are some screenshots here of inside GPA. Microsoft has gone ahead and written maybe over 250 reports inside SSRS that we can use as a springboard into getting exactly what you need. They span modules. Some of them are multi-companies. A ton of them have parameters on them. But the first thing is that you need to get them lit up. And so this is just a quick little screenshot here of what you need to do. So if they're not installed on your server, they're on the second CD of GPA, we have to first install them on there, and then we have to get GPA to recognize it. And then it's just a one-time only setup over here where we're just going ahead and saying deploy them. And then they're put into there. You can see also the Excel reports. There's a couple of hundred of those as well. So as you deploy it, you can be deploying both the SQL Server reports and the Excel reports, and this is just a one-time only setup. So you could write your own from scratch, but I don't think you need to do that because there is so many reports that ship with GPA that my suggestion is to go ahead and just get those reports installed so that you can go ahead and start to use them. And, you know, sometimes it's easy just to go ahead and take those reports and see, you know, trace them back and see, okay, what tables did they do? Where did they get the information that I'm seeing on my screen and being able to trace it back? So once you go ahead and you do what was on the previous screen, all it's going to want to know is that where is the URL that the reports are going to be on there. And this is just going to be the internal website that is where people go ahead and see the reports. You can also, there are some authentication options you can have over here. And I'll take you into the live product in a second and show you what the screen looks like. And there also are some deployment options. You can see here that we've installed the reports for all of these companies, and there's one company that's not deployed yet. So you just want to go ahead and deploy that. And you can always redeploy all the reports. So if you find that you only took some of them in, we can go ahead and just redeploy them and update the screens. Okay, you can use all these SSRS reports that ship with GPA. Once they're lit up and you get them installed, you can use them on a navigation list. So this is your classic navigation list over here, and you can see here's all the reports, and there's a couple of options that happen over here. So the toolbar over here goes ahead and allows you to view the report. You can actually edit the report right inside GPA. So this will take you into the Report Builder 3.0, and you can make any changes you want. You can also go into the SSRS reporting services itself, and you could also export it. So what you're seeing here, and actually I'll take you to the product and we'll look at it inside there. Okay, let's go into GP and see how some of this is done. So this is Business Analyzer, and inside Business Analyzer, this is outside of GP, but it actually is running the SSRS reports. So you can see a lot of these are just pretty, you know, they look like pretty pictures, like, you know, my top 12 customers by the year. Here I'm using a cross-company aging report. Now this would not be possible in GP unless I'm using multi-entity management, but inside SSRS it is possible. So what I can do is I can take an aging across databases. So I'm able to go ahead and report on multiple databases in a single report. You know, here I'm able to go ahead and do some data visualization. So these, again, are the repeatable, highly formatted reports. Microsoft has built a ton of them. That's why I'm trying to just stress, leverage these for sure. And sometimes you don't want them looking so graphical, and that's fine. There's tons of reports that you can go ahead and do them. So let's go ahead and see how many reports we actually have. Okay, let me just minimize this. Okay, so these are the different reports. The way I got to this was I was inside Business Analyzer, and you can get them in GP as well. And I just go into the corner here, and I just hover, and I just say Options, and I say Report Selection. And now I'm going ahead and selecting what reports I want to see. So you can see they're broken into categories or folders, and you'll see a different representation of this once we get into the report manager itself. But these are basically just done by companies. This is the bike company, the Canadian company, the configuration, Fabrican Foundation. Here's some multi-company reports. And then they're done, and just they're organized and in categories. So you can see under financial, let's just go ahead and get a better view here. There's a multi-company cost of goods sold year to date. If I want to see these reports in Business Analyzer, which this product ships with GP, so this is outside of it, but I can also see the same reports inside of it. I just highlight the report and just say insert, and now it's going to be on my rotation on the tray down there. But I don't want to, this is not a training on Business Analyzer right now. What I want to be able to highlight is that these are all the reports that are in there, and you can see where they're located. So you see the information over here, and this allows us to edit them. And then as we go further down, I go into, you know, here I can see that they're all done by different categories. Okay, so let's go over to GP for a second and see how do you get these reports installed. Just minimize this for a second. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to go into Tools and you want to go into Setup. And then once you go into System, here's where you go into the reporting options. So it's Reporting Tools Setup. So again, this is a one-time only setup. So once you go ahead, you're going to give it some deployment methods. If you're using SharePoint, then go ahead and do it on SharePoint. If you're not using SharePoint, you'll just choose Native, and that means it'll go to a URL. You get the, you'll have the ability here to say either the SharePoint site, or if you go Native, you would say what your internal URL is going to be for where you get to these reports. And then you can do some stuff here with credentials. So you can go ahead and say, do you want to just use Windows Authentication? I'm going to give people security for these reports, or do I want to have them be able, do I want to force them to log in to see the report? So I'm using Windows Authentication for all of these reports, and this is the same screen over here we use to deploy our Excel reports. So you can go ahead and say redeploy, and then just click on the deploy reports, and all of the reports are deployed. Okay, under the administration tab of GP, you're going to see here there's some items. You could go to your Excel reports there as well, but here I want to go into reporting service reports. Okay, so a fair number of the reports that are inside GP are actually written with SSRS. So if you look here, you can see the series. So I'm going to go ahead and just choose the trial balance, the AIDS trial balance. This is the same report I get to by going into my reports and being able to do it in the accounts receivable module or the sales processing module. But what this means is that you've got the ability here to edit them. And so if you find that there's a couple of fields that you want to take out, there's just some extraneous information, and you want to go ahead and move some columns around, a lot of these reports that are done inside GP, you can edit just by clicking on this edit button here. But I'll go into that a little bit later. Right now I just want to show you that you have the ability to view them. Okay, so now you're seeing what is in the interface. You're seeing what's called parameters. So one of the ways to go ahead and make a report reusable to a very large audience is to put a series of questions inside there. So in this case, these are the same questions that I'm being prompted for on the screen. You know, from starting customer to ending customer, what do I want, detail or summary? And, you know, I'll just take it down a few more customers. And you can see there's quite a lot of questions. These are the same questions that are being asked of you on the screen in the GP interface. And you can see here is a report. So these reports are actually SSRS reports. So like for instance, I have over here user defined one, and it says retail. If I want to change that wording from user defined one, and I just want to change the wording to say type of customer or whatever's more meaningful, or I find that the territories, everyone's got the same territory, I want it out of there, you've got the ability here just to edit the reports and just make them look exactly the way you want them to. Okay, so that was just a brief demonstration of how this stuff is folded inside GP. So, and again, you can get to them from the Business Analyzer, you can get them from the navigation list, and they're also embedded all throughout the product. And in addition to the standard reports that are out there, we also have all of these, those, you know, pretty pictures, the beautiful charts, the KPIs that you can do. So this is actually the home page of SQL Server Reporting Services. So you can see that it's got data sources. This is independent of GP. This is now, we're just in the SQL Server Reporting Services homepage, and you can have different sources for reports. So the data sources are just, where do I get the information that I need in my report? It could be a GP database, it could be another SQL Server database, it could be an Excel file. So you're just saying, where is the source of my data? And then the thing is, you want to definitely want to, because you have a large number of reports, you want to get everything into folders. So it's organizing it all in folders. We're all used to folders from our Outlook, from our network shares. So you can go ahead and do series folders, which is breaking it up by modules. You can do multi-company folders, which are reports that span companies. You can do report models, custom folders, and custom reports. So this is just a way for it to organize it. And then you can also get to Report Builder over here right from there. So let's just go over quickly some components of a report. So the first thing you need to know is the data source, and I just mentioned that earlier. Where is the data coming from? So if you're if you've never gone into SQL Server, you know, you might want to just reach out to us and get a list of the data dictionaries, or go in there and see, you know, where the data is coming from. I mean, do not edit the data in SQL, but you can definitely read and get the information in there. So if it's GP, GP's got a lot of tables. You just want to be familiar with them. I always say that there's like the usual suspects. Maybe there's 10 or 12 tables that have really all the information you want. A lot of other stuff is has less information, and you can always either join or union tables together, which is where you have a data set. So if you go ahead and you see some of the information in the customer, you have, like by way of example, you have customer transactions, and you want to go ahead and supplement that with some information from the customer master. We'll need to join those two tables to get the information you require. Parameters are just a great way to take a report and make it very flexible. You'll have it be able to ask questions. A typical thing would be a starting date range. You know, you're doing a sales report. If you put in from 1-1 to 3-31, you have a quarterly report. If you say from 1-1 to 1-1, it's a daily report. If you say from 1-1 to 12-31, it's a year-to-date report. So I think you probably get the idea. And you can ask as many questions as you want in the report. And then just to get the report looking good, you want a great report layout. Okay, so just a deeper dive into the data source. That defines where the data originates. Is it a SQL table, is it an Excel spreadsheet, etc. It's best if it's set up as shared, so it can be used for multiple reports. And we can go ahead and do these as stored procedures. We can go ahead and do some views inside SQL. So if you find that you're always joining the same information together, then let's get a view or a stored procedure set up so that you don't have to keep joining the information or requesting it. And this is good for security. Security is all built in there. It's coming right out of the SQL Server security. And GP's BI deployment tool creates a data source for each company, which happens for you automatically. Okay, so let's go ahead and just do a short demonstration about Report Manager. So you can see I'm inside here. I'm inside the Report Manager. And you can see this is the URL that I actually went ahead and did from when I was inside GP and I pointed to it. So if I wanted to get to the same sales information I had before, here's all the reports that I have. Here's my charts and KPIs. Organizing it by a folder structure just makes it a little bit easier to be able to find information because you probably have a lot of, will end up having a lot of reports. So this is the same report I had before where I asked for the questions or my parameters. And now I go ahead and see the report. So this is a way I'm not inside GP, but I'm getting the GP information. And I have the ability here to go ahead and drill down to it anytime I need to, as long as I set the report up that way. So let me take you into Business Analyzer, because you can see here I've got the top 12 customers by year to date. So here's some of the stuff I can do inside here. I can go ahead and show the report information. Any of these reports, when I go to view them, and I can do the same thing in the navigation list inside GP. You know, I can always double click on it and drill down further, but I can also, any of the SSRS reports are exportable. So what that means is that I can go ahead and put it into a PDF if I want to go ahead and put it into a presentation. I can put it into a Word document if I want to do that. I can put it into an Excel file if I want, or an XML. So you're able to export any of this data. Okay, but what I want to show you right now is that you also can go ahead and edit this information, and you can do the same thing I'm doing here inside the navigation list inside GPay. So when I say edit the report, this is going to call up the Report Builder 3.0. And what that is that traditionally SQL Server Reporting Services has been more of a developer type tool. So people did a lot of work in Visual Studio. But now we're hooked up into a Report Builder. And the Report Builder gives us like a wizard-like interface. So here I have the ability. So here I have the ability to see how the report was written. So I mean, it takes you, there's a little bit of training. Maybe, you know, you come to a one-day class and we get you going. Everyone needs to do different reports, so different people can have that. But you can see here that I've got my data sources, and here's my data sources in GP. Here's a data set which I was referring to, and here I went ahead and I just selected all the fields that I needed. Again, these reports are pre-built, so you can go ahead and do a deeper dive and be able to see what comes in there. And then I can do parameters. So here I've set up these questions, where anytime I want to say a new parameter, I just right-click and I can add parameters quickly and easily. And these just allow me to go in there and ask more questions, starting dates, customer types, whatever might be meaningful to me. But in this case, what I want to do is I just want to change the number of customers. And so I'm going to go ahead and do default value, and I'm going to say take it from 12 down to 10. I mean, I could add more information in here just by putting more information in there. I could put more images in, et cetera, et cetera. And if I wanted to go ahead and change, you can see the bars across the top, very, very similar to what you're used to in Excel and Word. But in this case, I'm just going to save the report. And let's just exit out of here. And then when I'm going to right-click here and I'm going to reload the reports, and then it'll just go ahead and change my top 12 customers to my top 10 customers. So that's running over here. I just want to, it'll just take a minute or two. And all of these reports you can go ahead and edit, which might be the best way to go ahead and get an introduction, unless you're using SSRS already, to see how the reports are actually baked. Okay, so you can see here just by, it changes the top 10. So if I wanted to do the top 15, top 20, etc. But it's pretty easy to go in there and just be able to make some small changes. And those changes, you could also, if you don't want to do, if you're not using Business Analyzer and you're working inside GP, then you can always go ahead and just edit the report right out of here. So again, I deployed the reports first, and then I went into my administration tab on these buttons over here, and I just went into reporting services, and it brought up all the reports that I have that are in SSRS. Okay, so there's a couple of things I just want to point out about types of data sets. So there's embedded, where we're just going ahead and we're just in every single report, you're calling up the information you want specifically. And that's fine, the report will definitely work. It's just that it's not very portable between reports. You have to keep in every single report, you need to define exactly what fields you want. And so the query must be evaluated by the server each time the report is run. Which again, it's fine. I mean, it just might not be the most efficient way to do it, but it'll definitely work. But the better way of doing it is to do some shared data sets. So if we find the rows asking for the same set of data, we want to go ahead and define that inside SQL. So SQL's got a ton of power, which is one of the advantages of it. You know, this is, and it's an enterprise scalable database that, you know, you can just do tons of stuff with. So we want to start taking advantage of that. You know, you have your accounting up and running. Now we want to get you the information you need. So the shared data set is portable because it can be used in multiple reports. And it can be updated separately from the reports that use it. So this is either a stored procedure in SQL or a view. So a view is when we just go ahead and aggregate information. So as you update the view, you don't have to update the 13 reports that use that view. They'll just benefit from the one update inside SQL. So this is a sort of a recap You know, we select from tables, we select customer number from, this is a receivable management 101 table. So it's just, you know, sort of a glimpse at what the GP data looks like from the back end. But if we do views, it's similar to using the tables, but we can go ahead and just ask for the information specifically and save it into a view. And a stored procedure is even faster. And we can just go ahead and just use the name of the stored procedure inside the query, and you're good to go. The next item is parameters, and parameters are those questions. And they can be different types. They can be dates, drop-down lists, strings, numerics. And you can also have parameters dependent upon other parameters. So depending on what you answer to the first question, it limits your responses to the second question. So you can build a fair amount of intelligence into this. Okay, so we're just nearing the end of the presentation. So I just wanted to, everyone's going to have different reports they're going to need, but we're all going to want to go ahead and use some best practices. And some of the best practices are use report templates. So that this way we go, that you go ahead and you can start recycling some of them. Use shared data sources. Don't go directly to the tables if you're writing the same reports over and over again using the same information. So either get a view going or a stored procedure. And also use the navigation features. So you can go ahead and use it inside GPA. And then I just want to leave you, there's a couple of resources that I would think I would definitely recommend. One of them is there's some books out there, you know, and there's SQL Server 2012 Reporting Services. This is just a good library. Of course, there's tons of information online.